Hello, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you exactly how any trader can calculate the position size and know exactly what their risk is before they enter a trade. It's an amazing concept that many traders fail to grasp, and I'm going to show you why that happens in the mind that so many traders can't seem to manage their risk and get good results from trading. With the popularity of using brokers and prop trading firms who offer to fund your account if you get good results, more people are discovering the need to learn to manage their risk. Because in order to pass an evaluation or a challenge with a prop trading firm, it's imperative that you abide by the set rules of how much can you lose per trade, how much can you lose per day. This is the most important thing to learn in trade. It's far more important than anything to do with a trading system, a trading strategy, or technical analysis of any kind. Is far more important than understanding support and resistance, supply and demand, or price action. It's far more important than any aspect of technical analysis. And the day that you get this and choose to adopt it as a permanent change in your behavior, a lifetime habit with no exceptions, is the day that you start to master trading. If you don't know how much you are risking when you enter a trade, it won't do any good to know the most advanced trading strategy, even if it's the most effective trading strategy in the world. Now, this book is something that has been the thing that inspired many of the traders who actually succeed in trading. And the one big breakthrough that happens when people read this book is suddenly they realize, oh, I should know my risk. Traders who don't know their risk are the traders who will lose their accounts. I remember a guy who was planning to trade as a full-time business. He was planning to start trading as a full-time business. And he had $1,000 in his account. And I was suggesting to him that he might want to use a position size or a lot size, 0.1 lot. Now, you're going to see in a minute that that's not accurate. There's a much better way to figure out your lot size other than just a certain amount, like 0.1 lot size. And he said, no, I can't trade with 0.1 lot. I have to trade with a full standard lot, or it's not even worth it for me to be trading. Well, as you will see in a moment, that would mean that he is likely to lose his entire account on the first one or two trades. If they don't work out, he'll just lose it. Now, why is it that so many traders expect to be able to gamble their account and to get results that have never been possible to get and statistically would not be likely to get? Well, the biggest problem with casino gambling and with Forex trading is people's willfully ignorant and illogical beliefs and denial of reality and the facts regarding knowing the risk of a trade and the likelihood that that particular trade will be contributing to a sound plan for consistent increase. We can all have winners and losers in trading as long as they all are contributing to a consistent increase over time. As human beings, we all know the reality of basic math and statistics and probability. Why would anyone deny probability and pretend that it doesn't exist for them or that it doesn't apply to that person? Why would someone start with a small account and believe that they will somehow get results that have never been done before? They're just extremely unlikely to happen. Why would they expect that they will somehow surpass normal probability and somehow get lucky multiplying their account right from the beginning? It seems like every person would know that if they're learning to trade, that would mean that they're going to lose money. Learning to trade, losing money, these two things are the same and go together. How could they not? Not losing money, that would mean that you're not learning to trade. That would mean that you have already mastered a rare skill that few people ever achieve. So not losing money, that would be something that could happen later on after you have developed the skill. Unrealistic expectations is the most destructive mental state that causes people to give up, causes people to fail in trading. And so why do people open a small account and then just risk the whole account, or risk, you know, 10% of the account on one trade, and then wonder why they lose it quickly, like lose all the account in 1 week? Wonder why that happens. So let's make sure that does not happen to you, that you learn right from the beginning how to manage your account so that when you do develop the skill of having consistent increase, you could have consistent increase with 50% of your trades being winning trades if your winning trades are larger than your losses. That's not too hard to achieve if you manage your account properly. Okay, so the first thing that we should all know is how much should you risk per trade? Well, industry-wide, it's known that 1 to 2% of your account is a standard amount to risk per trade. And there are ways of finding out even more accurately what would be the best thing for you to risk based on your past performance and the average number of winning trades versus losing trades, and how big your winning trades are versus your losing trades. If you have a 1 to 2 risk to reward ratio, so that all of your winning trades average at least twice as many pips as your losing trades, then your account will increase. Also, what percentage of your trades win versus what percentage of your trades lose. And there are also factors of, even if you have a high percentage of winning trades, what would be the likelihood of having a certain number of losing trades in a row? And we don't know how many losing trades in a row we will have, but we can tell from past performance how that has happened in the past, and that might be able to guide us. But some traders have mentioned that expecting that you may sometime have 5 losing trades in a row, expecting you might have 10 losing trades in a row, what would that do to your account? Now, if you risk more than 1% or 2% of your account on a regular basis in your trading, that would need to be based on proof of your own account showing that your percentage of winning trades is consistently higher than average. If the number of winning trades that you have are 60% average or 70% average, or maybe even 80% or more, then it might be justified to use a larger amount of your risk per trade, because you could keep on entering trades, and with that percentage of winning trades, it would be okay to have larger losses if they are a smaller percentage of them. But let's say that you are trading an evaluation or a challenge with a prop trading firm, like I've noticed with FTMO. There is a set rule not to be able to lose more than 0.5% of your account per trade. You can't even lose 1% of your account per trade. And with a $10,000 account, 1% loss would be $1,000. You can't lose $1,000. $500 is the most. So that's 0.5%. So you would need to know that if you're going to do that evaluation for the prop trading firm. Now, if your percentage of winning trades is higher, then it might be justified for you to use a higher percentage. It would just mean that you decided not to make as much money as you could mathematically. And you would also have to prove it first. So if you're coming to the table without a long proof of past performance, Well, then you don't have anything to base your desire to have higher risk per trade. But when you enter a trade, let's say I'm analyzing a chart, we're not going to get into that aspect of things, but let's say that I am looking for a long entry to occur on this US dollar, and then I'm looking for a short entry to occur after going up, maybe one more time. When I see this later, let's say if I was looking for a short entry on this, first thing I would do is once that happened, which it hasn't happened, but once it happened, I would enter the trade and put my stop loss at the most recent high, because that would be the place that would invalidate the trade. So when you enter a trade, do you understand the reason why you enter, and therefore understand what price level would invalidate that entry so that it's no longer a valid trade? The idea of hoping to never be wrong and resisting having a simple loss by just staying in the trade and going negative and hoping that soon it's going to turn is caused by a core belief that most of us have but must be reprogrammed in order to trade successfully. Now, one of the best Forex calculators you can use is this one from Google Play for Android, and it's called Forex Calculators. It has this little logo on it. This is a screenshot of it, and it's a pretty useful tool for calculating your position size properly. But it's just for Android. It's just for a mobile phone. It's not for desktop. It's not for an iPhone, and so it may be limiting to people for those reasons. Okay, so another place where you can find a decent position size calculator is at babypips.com. So simply Google position size calculator and you will find a result at babypips.com that will enable you to put in the values that you would like and then have it calculated. The one limitation with that is if you choose some cross pair or something other than the euro US dollar and you put in the euro Aussie, and you will have to also put in the spread of the Aussie versus the dollar or something in order to get the data to calculate that. So that's a little bit cumbersome. It's a little bit of a limitation. So another place you can find a good position size calculator to help you to figure out what position size you should enter when you enter a trade is at Duca's Copy position size calculator. This one will enable you to change the instrument to something other than euro US dollar or a major pair and still have it automatically calculate the right position size without you having to know something else or put something else into that. So that makes the Duca's Copy a little bit more user-friendly, a little bit more accurate. Okay, another solution that you can use to help you to calculate your position size properly is the built-in position size calculator inside of Tradingview. But what I have found is if your broker doesn't connect with Tradingview, then the position size calculator is not really useful. So, and once again, to explain, Tradingview can be used as a charting platform, and then you can enter trades through your broker. But if you wanted to enter trades through Tradingview with your other broker, it has to connect. And when I tried using the position size calculator without connecting my broker, I discovered that it wasn't really useful. So you can use that if you want. But another thing you can do is if you use MetaTrader 4 or MetaTrader 5, there are several lot size calculator, position size calculators that can be used that will help you to automatically calculate your position size on the fly when you're entering a trade and the price is changing. It's difficult to keep track of the current price when it's changing. So this is one that you can use. There are several of these, and you can find this also on Google by searching lot size, position size, MetaTrader 5, and you will find these things. And so this is one that comes up that is kind of useful, and all you do is you fill in the information that you need. In fact, what you want to do is put in the percentage that you choose to use for your risk, and then it already knows the amount in your account And then when you apply the entry price and the stop loss price, then the position size is the part that is adjustable. A lot of people never realize that the position size is the part that is adjustable, because they think the stop loss is how you get lower risk, not the position size. And that's a mistake. So the stop loss is placed for a technical reason, what would invalidate the trade, but the position size is the part that you would adjust. The sooner you get used to understanding that, you must understand that. If you don't understand that, you might as well just hang it up. Forget about trading. First step in trading, understand how to adjust your position size. If you're not doing it, you're just playing a gambling game and you're just hoping to get lucky. Now that you have that down, you are on your way to success in trading. Now that you have this secret, which isn't a secret, why is it everyone is telling us this from the very beginning and still we ignore it? This is the thing that will propel you on the path to success in trading. Now, I've made another video about the subject, and watch that right over here.